Hello students, chapter 1, the living world. In continuation with the first video where we had discussed about the difference between living and non-living thing and tried to identify the defining property of living, in this video we'll be talking about the diversity in the living world. Now, if you students look around yourself, where you live, you see large variety of living organisms. You see different insects, birds, many animals and many varieties of plants. Now, the more you increase the area of which you explore, more number of organisms are seen. There are some organisms which you cannot even see with your naked eyes, the microbes. They are also present in that area. If you visit a dense forest, obviously you will come across much greater number and much different types of living organism. Now, these different kinds of plants, these different kinds of animals, organisms that you see around yourself is known as species, is represented as species. Now, in today's date, nearly 1.7 to 1.8 million species have been discovered. So, the number and types of organism present in this earth is known as what? Biodiversity. Students, if you explore new areas, obviously you are going to find more number of species, new number of species. But even if you explore the old areas, every time you explore, you are going to find new organisms. New organisms will be identified. There are millions of plants and animals in this world. And these plants and animals are known by their local names. And these local names vary from place to place. Not only from country to country, within the country also, the local names are different. Like for example, dog, very simple. Dog, we call it in English. Kutta, we call it in Hindi. Kukur, we call it in Sanskrit. And we have so many languages. In every language, we'll be calling it by a different name. So, it can create a lot of confusion. We are talking about the same organism, but we still don't know. Why? Because we are calling it by a different name. Now, to avoid this confusion, we need to standardize the naming of the living organism, such that the particular organism is known by the same name all over the world. And this process is known as nomenclature. So, you can see over here, how can you define nomenclature? It is the science of providing distinct names to organisms so that they can be easily recognized and differentiated from others. Now, obviously, nomenclature or naming is possible only when the organisms is described correctly. And this describing of an organism is known as identification. So, how do we define identification? Finding a correct name and a place of an organism in the system is called identification. I repeat again, finding a correct name and place of an organism in the system of classification is known as identification. Because if we can identify the organism properly, then only we can give it a name. Now, in order to remove the confusion of calling a particular organism by different name, scientists, they formulated some rules based on which the names were given to the organism. Like, for example, plants. For plants, scientific names are based on principles given by International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. And animals, animal taxonomists have evolved International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. And a scientific name of an organism has two parts. The very first part is the generic name and the second part is the specific epithet or the name of the species. Now, this type of nomenclature where each name has two components is known as binomial nomenclature. The scientific name ensures that each organism has only one name. And description of any organism enables the people to arrive at the same name. And this binomial nomenclature was given by Carlos Linnaeus. Like, for example, mango is named as Magnifera indica. Here, Magnifera represents the genus and indica represents species. So now let us see what are the universal rules for nomenclature. The very first thing, biological names are generally in Latin and written in italics. They are Latinized or derived from Latin irrespective of their origin. Now, you may discover the organism from anywhere, but the name given will be Latin or Latinized. The first word in the biological name represents the genus, while the second component denotes the specific epithet, that is, the species. Like we just now said, Magnifera indica. Magnifera belongs to genus and indica belongs to species. Both the words in biological name, when handwritten, are separately underlined. It's very, very necessary. It is compulsory to underline it if you are handwriting it. Or if it is printed, then it will be printed in italics to indicate their Latin origin. Fourth point, the first word denoting genus starts with a capital letter, while the specific epithet starts with a small letter. You can see over here, Magnifera indica, because Magnifera is the genus, M is capital and indica belongs to species, so I is small. Now, name of the author who has given the name appears after the specific epithet at the end of the biological name. For example, Magnifera indica Linn. What does Linn describes? Linn describes Linnaeus. That means Linnaeus gave this name. Now let's talk about classification. Students, why is it necessary to classify the living organism? We all know that we have just now studied about 1.7 to 1.8 million organisms are there. And it is impossible to study all the living organisms. So, to make the study easy, we have to devise some means, and that is known as what? Classification. So what is classification? It is a process by which anything is grouped into convenient categories based on some easily observable characters. For example, we can easily recognize groups such as plants or animals, or dog or cats or insects. Now children, whenever these terms are being used, immediately you can picturize that organism. The image of that organism appears to you. Obviously, if I say dog, a picture of a dog will come in your mind, not of that of a cat. Now, in case if I am talking about specific breed of that dog, like if I talk about Alsatians or Labrador, then that specific breed will come in your as an image in you, in your mind. Similarly, suppose we say mammals. Immediately you will think about what? Animals with external ears and body hairs. Likewise, if we talk about wheat, the picture of wheat will come in your mind. Rice, then rice. So, dog, cat, mammal, wheat, rice, plant, animal. Talk about any given example, any other. They are convenient categories we use to study organism. And the scientific term for these categories is known as what? Taxa. But here, students, taxa indicates categories at different level. Like for example, I told you, plant is a taxa. Wheat is also a taxa. Animal, mammal, dogs, all are taxa, but they all belong to different categories. They do belong to different levels. Like dog, we all know dog is a mammal and mammals are animals. Therefore, animal, mammal, dog, they all represent taxa at different level. Now let's talk about taxonomy. What is taxonomy? It is a branch of biology that deals with identification, nomenclature, and classification of organism. See, just now we had talked about nomenclature. We had talked about identification. And just now, third thing, classification. So, branch of biology that deals with all these three things, identification, nomenclature, classification of organism, is known as what? Taxonomy. Now, when we are identifying any organism or we are classifying any organism, we have to take into consideration some similarities or some dissimilarities. Some characteristics. We have to consider some characteristics. So, which characteristics do we go study about? Consider about external and internal structures. Then structure of cell, development, process, ecological information of organism. These are some of the essential characteristics based on which we can classify the organism and based on which our modern taxonomy is based. So as I told you just now, what is the basis of taxonomy? Characterization, identification, classification and nomenclature are the basis of taxonomy. there is a word known as systematics. Students, taxonomy and systematic to many of the biologists is synonymous. But many of them think that there is a slight difference between taxonomy and systematic. Systematic is also a branch of science that deals with classification, identification, nomenclature, but it also considers evolutionary relationship between organisms. Systematic takes into account evolutionary relationship between organisms. Taxonomy does not do that. This word systematics has derived from Latin word systema, in which systematic arrangement of organism, which means systematic arrangement of organism. Carlos Linnaeus had published a book, and the name of his book, title of his publication was Systema Naturae. So, what is the difference between systematic and taxonomy? Taxonomy includes identification, nomenclature, and classification. But systematics goes one step ahead. It takes into consideration evolutionary relationship between organisms, from where these organisms have evolved. Thank you.